Hey, how y'all doing tonight? All right, for these boys in here, man, y'all be spitting some shit. I come in here and think. Yeah, be hurting a little bit. Smoke me a blunt on that. The little crowd I heard tonight, though, how you guys doing? Everybody good. Things have changed a lot, you know, and I'm an older guy, man, in my 30s. You guys think that's old, but y'all are bigger, so it's not like that. Don't ask me anything. But things have changed, man. I seen something the other day that was kind of disturbing, man. I went to Dollar General or General Dollar right there on Colonel Glenn, man. And I seen this little girl, man. She was all about 6 years old. And she was doing something that little black kids don't do. She was in the store showing her ass. And all of y'all who grew up with real black parents, don't act like y'all don't know what showing your ass is. Y'all looking at me like I said something wrong. And the mother didn't snatch her. She didn't whoop her. She didn't beat her child in the store. Now, I know some of y'all are thinking, wow, why should she beat her child in the store? Because damn it, that's what good black parents do. You don't embarrass your parents, they embarrass you. So I'm the only person that got that motherfucker speech before you go in the store. Don't ask for shit, because you ain't getting shit. Don't touch shit, because you ain't getting shit. Don't look at shit, because you ain't getting shit. I'm the only one. Y'all gonna sit here quiet like y'all didn't get that speech. Everybody was rich, huh? I go throwback. Y'all remember the real food stamps? You had to turn around the book. Who that old man? Who that old man? You remember that? Yeah. Yeah. Well, I say all that to say, if you ain't beating the shit out your kids, please start. Because we got a bunch of them running around wearing skinny jeans and doing outlandish shit. Like coming to my job 5 minutes before it closed and demanding shit. For real, if you work at a restaurant, man, do not go in there 5 minutes before it closes, man. Like, this is really what we thinking when the dough hit.
Hey, how you doing? You guys still open?
Can't even work here. You got your ass in here, don't you?
Yeah, sure you are. You guys aren't closing, are you?
Well, it's 5 minutes to close, and we close in 5 minutes, so no, we not closing. We just wiping all this stuff down and putting everything up, because we gonna stand there for the rest of the night. And then this motherfucker proceeds to order. Why do they always say, let me get a, listen, if you were that damn wrong, and you brought your nasty ass in here 5 minutes before we close, and Tamika ain't even gonna motherfucking wait, like, she might got started before, you know, and I might have to catch her. And, okay, so I'm the only one that got a freak. Okay. When you really want to get off work and you got something to do, let me just say it like that. Everybody in here all shy. You know, ain't nobody got no freak in them. You know.
Okay, I'll set your eyes like you don't find the ladies, you know.
But when somebody come in your job and they do that shit, tell the truth. You really want to say, man, you'll get your punk ass up out of this smoke. Right, but you can't do that. Because you got light, gas, rent, water. Yeah, bro, you know what I'm talking about. Bro, like, man, this is coming on. I've been wanting much every time they come in. It's like they wait 5 minutes before close to want the motherfucking Subway sandwich. Now you want the Subway sandwich. Meatball, sub with marinara. Oh, God damn. So, you know, that ain't even a joke. Just don't take your ass in there because we really want to cuss you the fuck out. We want to tell you, fuck you and your sandwich. Excuse my French. That's what we really want to say. Round of applause when y'all got kids in there. Anybody got kids? Kids. Are they at that cute age or they still like at that 3, 4, and 5 age? You know, 4 is your favorite. What, anybody else got a favorite age? 2, 0. 2 weeks, 8, 19. Well, I got a kid, man, and for a few years he was staying with his mom, and I got him like the last little few years before he get grown. And I'm fucking sick of his ass. I ain't gonna get that. Y'all ain't gotta laugh at that. Anybody want to adopt? Oh, like, I'm just saying because I was around him a lot when he was in the cute age. You know that you eat something and they come, give me
That shit ain't cute at 16. Nah, when you fix your plate, you sit down and eat this grown nigga talking about your missus. You wanna take your ass in there and fix you something? And I found out something because I asked him. I said, man, why did you do this shit? Like, because it was driving me, and I didn't want to just do what my parents used to do and just knock the shit out of you. Like, because I grew up with grandparents, and like, you got your ass whooped for anything. Like, if I ain't getting at least 3 or 4 ass whoops a day, I felt like my grandma was sick.
Grandma, you okay?
You ain't hit me with your purse once. So I asked my son, I said, say, man, I said, do you think that I get hungry and say, I'm going to go in here and fix you something to eat? Is that what you think in your mind? And he gave me the most. What? He gave me the answer. If your child gets to a certain age, they will give you an answer when you be like, you just give them that look like, please go that way. Go. He said, yes. Now, I thought he was joking until he explains his logic. He said, you're my dad. It is your job to provide. He got deep with it. He got deep. He said, it's your job to provide. Now, I was thinking what she said. I should beat you. Like, the old hip-hop parent came out, and I was like, I should just slap the shit out of him. Tomorrow when he wake up, he 35, and he like, I should have said that shit. But I decided to do one better, and I decided for us to start talking about his future in life. What he was going to do with himself. Especially around 18, which is about a year and a half away. Because I let him know I was going to give him a real nice birthday present for his 18th birthday. Can any of y'all figure out what he's getting for his 18th birthday? Anybody.
Silver one away party?
A car?
A couch.
I like her answer, but nah, I'm getting him luggage. Because at 11:59, I'm going to wake him up. I'm going to tell him, hey, my responsibility is over. Do you remember we had that talk the other day? Yeah, a couple years back. That's over. Yeah, my duty is done. You're 18 now, you gotta go. And I was thinking I should be nice and let him get his shit together. But then I was thinking about the comment that he made. It's my job to give him my goddamn food. Like, this the only ham sandwich in the house with mustard on it. And he proceeded to tell me that he ain't gotta get out of 18. I said, why the hell you ain't gotta get out of 18? Legally, they said I can throw your ass out at 18. I won't even get in trouble no more. Like, because if they under 18, you get in trouble kicking them out. And he said, because I'm going to college. And at that moment, man, I was proud and upset. Because I got to take care of this punk ass nigga for 4 more years. But I was proud because he said he's going to college. So, you know, as a black guy, man, you know, wild and bad man, you know, he said I'm going to college. I asked him what he was going to study, and he said, modern art and design. And I said, wow, my son's really intelligent. But yeah, just don't fucking figure out how to get a sandwich. So I don't really know how college is going to go, but I really hope it's not one of your deals. So I'm just saying, listen, as a parent, you got to be real with yourself. You know, you want to study modern art and design, but you can't put a sandwich together. It's 2 pieces of bread and a piece of meat. But I don't get home when I do that shit. Like, what? It's ham, cheese, and bread. And ramen noodles. Damn, I'm glad I ain't going to college. Y'all right now. Oh, wait a minute. What the joke? I was mad at college, they charged y'all all the goddamn money. I should have whooped somebody there. Okay, I got one more joke. And I'm gonna let her get up here. I got one more. I know I don't look like it, but I'm in a different tax bracket and I found out some real stuff. We all black here except for you, and you're gonna just have to ride with it. So, I'm in a different tax bracket. So the first thing they do when you get a digital tax bracket, they take more money out your motherfucking check. Now, as a black person, we don't want nothing coming out of our shit. We trying to carry 12 dependents and drop them motherfuckers like right before time. So they know, you know, trying to get, take them off of there. I got them online, shit. So I call the people because I want to understand, you know, why I'm making less money when I got a raise, which is only 2%. And in my mind, I'm thinking 2%, damn, they fuck me. But I know they really fuck me. Till I call the IRS.
hello, the IRS, how may I help you?
So I explained my situation. I said, ma'am, I got a raise, but I'm getting less money on my check. And when she heard it, it sounded normal. I guess it's something normal, because she wasn't even surprised. And that kind of offended me, because this was like, and? Where my $10 at? I'm in the suburb. $10 is my fucking. How many tables? 2, 4, 6. I give you guys a game. $10. That's all I'm saying. I don't know about y'all black people, but broke black people, I stretch $10 like no other. You have too much, we get air and pay that. You like that, damn. So the lady tells me she's explaining this whole.
Life.
Okay, I guess it's too long. We're gonna let him be. Oh, that's a good one though, man. I ain't thinking it. Right. No. So the lady go on to see to tell me, you know, why I ain't getting my money. So I'm a little upset. You know, and all I kept thinking, anybody remember that dream song? I just kept hearing that one. Why the whole time I talked to the lady, all I kept hearing in the back of my mind was, feeling real black right now. Real black right now. I'm just so funny, man. That's been hot. Yeah.